Welcome to DMP Training Center. I'm Adam Barton, corporate trainer at DMP. And today we're going to talk about some updates that we've made to our Z-Wave devices, specifically the ability to add appliance devices to the system. So examples of appliance devices would include something like we have here, a water shutoff switch, as well as blind controllers. There are a few requirements that you have to have in place to be able to support these newer devices. For your XT or XR panels, you have to have firmware version 192. Your keypad, touchscreen keypad, has to be at version 203. And you need to make sure that you have version 105 of the 738Z+. If you're unsure of what version you have with your Z-Wave module, you can go into the diagnostics menu of any of our panels to gather that information. The appliance module learns in like anything else on the system as far as Z-Wave's concerned. So all those same familiar options that you've had on other devices apply here. You can add a Z-Wave device from the user menu on the keypad. Customers can add devices from the virtual keypad app, and technicians can also use the tech app to learn these devices in. So no real changes there. After you've added an appliance module, it'll actually show up in the light section on the carousel of the touchscreen keypad. And we're gonna go ahead and take a look at that to see what it looks like and compare it to maybe a standard light that's already been learned into the system. Okay, so here we are at the keypad. We've already learned in our appliance module. Once it's learned in, you're gonna find that appliance module in the lights section. So if we scroll through our carousel, we see our option for lights. We're gonna select that. And here you can see I already have a lamp learned in. We're familiar with that icon and what it looks like. But over here on the left, we have our appliance. So you see it's the power icon there with the on and off, and we've given it the name water shutoff. And we can control this directly from here. If we had this in a favorite, it could also be triggered from a favorite. So as you can see, the appliance modules are really straightforward to work with. They're easy to find on the keypad. And again, you get all that nice integration that you've come to expect between DMP and Z-Wave. So thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Have a great day.
So as you know, we've always had the ability to control lights, locks, and thermostats from the keypad or the virtual keypad. But with this new integration, now you have the ability to take advantage of other custom features for Z-Wave appliances, such as water valves and motorized blinds. So for example, if you have a customer that has a remote cabin or a vacation home, they might want the ability to control and make sure that they've shut off the water valve remotely. They can easily do that without even having to log in by having a favorite that they can control from their iPhone. Or perhaps they want to do a custom action because they've installed a water sensor. So you have a water sensor that when triggered, triggers a custom action that shuts off the water valve. They might have favorites that go ahead and roll up the blinds for them. Or perhaps they want to put those on a schedule that follows sunrise or sunset. So there's a lot of added flexibility in addition to what we've already had. Again, we already had Z-Wave lights, locks, and thermostats, but now we're adding the ability to control Z-Wave appliances such as water shutoff valves or motorized blinds. And these can be done from the virtual keypad app and the various features that are controlled there, or through the actual DMP keypad, they'll have full control of these as well. So this is a powerful feature that adds a lot of flexibility and a lot of new opportunities for you and your customers. So thank you for spending time with us, and thank you for your business. Have a great day.